So, now that we have our blueprints aligned, we're ready to start drawing curves. I'm going to be starting with this front top cowl of the scooter because I think it's the toughest one. Before we start drawing the curves though, I want to see what we're dealing with. So, here it is. As you can see, it's very strange plastic. I think it's the hardest I've ever modeled so far. But I've studied it a lot, and you'll see how we'll progress with this. It turned out to be extremely easy once you realize how the surfaces are going. Here was the toughest part because, as you can see, the plastic here has some kind of a bend. Down to here, it seems to be roundish. So, anyway, let's start drawing those curves and we'll see as we progress how things are turning out. So, we'll be using the side view. Let me turn grid snap off and also snap off. As I said in previous tutorials, we'll try to use as less points as possible. Less points mean less errors on our surfaces. I'm using Alt and the arrows to move this around. Now, if you notice carefully on the real scooter, we have this slight bend over here that goes a bit higher than this line here. So I'm going to be using it slightly lower. Let's see. I always make sure that the points are on the same angle. I guess we're fine with the side view. Now we have to match this. Probably using the right view. So let's take this point and using ortho snap off. Let's pull it over here. As you can see. However, this point is supposed to be somewhere over here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to move my blueprint a bit lower so that this point here . As I said, we knew all along that the blueprints weren't going to align properly on every angle, but now that I want to work at the top part of the bike, I think it's safe to do this. So, let's take this one and pull it somewhere over here. Now let's take these ones. Let's use a top view for these ones. Let's put this here. Let's put this over here. So, by typing setpt, I'm going to align these three points using the top view. Now, let me show you something first. As you can see, this line here goes almost straight. Starts from here, it's very bright, but as you can see, it starts here. That slight bend goes almost straight up. And here it bends outwards again. So, we're drawing this curve over here. So I guess it's safe to put this on a straight line. So how do we do this? Take this one. Since I've used ortho snap before, I'm sure that they're on the same SIP lane. So I will be using, whoops. I will take this and let me bend them somewhere over here. I leave this, as I said before, because I know there's another part of the plastic there. So let me see. As you can see, they moved a bit from this view. Let me check. Let's make sure that this one, I'm using the point snap, by the way, to do this. Let me see. Let's see what happens in the front view. So this one has to go a bit more out. And let's put this. You see that the curve is doing like a circle here. I don't want that. Let me see the line. No, I'm not happy with it. So let me use the point snap. I think it's a bit better now. Let's take out the nearer snap using the point. Let's see, the bottom point is that one. So let me align this using this point. But I know that those are on straight line. That's a bit better now, I think. So as you can see, this bends outwards and then it goes back again inwards. Now I think it looks like I messed up the side blueprint, but that's okay. I think we're good now. Let's take this one as well, using the scale 1D. As long as it has a nice smooth curvature, I think we'll be okay. So you can't align it 100% properly in these blueprints, so I guess we're fine with this line. I'm saving the file. Let's go on and make some other lines. Let's make this one. It has some slight bend. Very slight, but it's there. So using the ortho snap, let's put it somewhere over here. I'm using the alt arrows again. We're fine with this one as well. Now, this one is a tricky one because we only have a side view. I'll just do it somewhere over here. I won't bother with this curve over here. As you can see, it's curvy, but this we will fix later on. So, as you can see, we have absolutely no top view of this. So the reference is going to have to help us. So let's see, as you can see, it's a bit more inside than this curve over here. So I'm going to guess for now, and I'm going to place it somewhere over here. I don't know where exactly this is, but we're going to fix this later. Let me put it a bit over here. So, let's go on now. We need another curve. So, let me show you how to do this. As I said, as you can see here, it's a straight curve, but here it bends inside the plastic. Let me show you from another view. Here, it's straight. It has a slight bend here, a roundish bend, and it goes in this line. So what we need here is a straight line . But before we do this, let's start using the mirror or snap from here. Let's put a point over there and another one here. So we want this to be aligned the same line. So using our point or snap, we'll do that. So, using the top view, as you can see, this plastic has this bend over here. So, let's take it here, and let's assume that this goes somewhere here. It's only an assumption. We don't know exactly where it goes, but as I can see from this view, I guess we're somewhere here. Now I want this to be curvy, so I will be using the fillet curves. Let's see if this works properly. It does. This is, I need way more than this. So I guess we're okay with this now. For now, let's say this one. Now it's a tricky part. Using the end of snap, I'm going to be using one line here and one line here. So why don't I just create the whole line? This is because the bottom part of this plastic needs to be almost perpendicular to this one. So if I want it to match properly, I have to have the less points I can. So I'm going with 2 points at this stage. So let me take this one and let's assume it's somewhere over here. And this one, let's see the blueprint, the reference photos, seems to be going straight. Let's put it almost parallel to this line. So now I'm going to use blend curves to match this using tangency. With slight error, I think we're there. Let's see this from the side though. You can see that this bend, which I don't like at all. Let's delete this. As you can see, there's also some slight curvature on the inside. Let's align this with this one. Now let's make the blend curves again. As you can see, there's still some slight bend that I don't like. So let's take this one and put it slightly more on the inside. I know it's a slow process, but I have to be thorough about it. I think I'm okay with this. So, as you can see, the plastic starts very smooth over here, has this creased edge here. So, let's start making this one. The toughest one of this plastic will be the bottom line over here. So I guess we're good over here. Great. So, using ortho snap. let's use this here. Let's place this over here where this curve starts. As you can see, these two points go outwards. They don't align, but as I said, it's not a problem. We're using the side view as our main view. Now let's take this one. The end of the blueprint here is actually this plastic. So let's take this over here. Now let's go with this one. I have this line, this curve down here. As you can see, this bottom part is supposed to match this line exactly. So I guess we're not okay from this view. So let's see. Let's give it some slight curvature. I think we're good. I'll show you how to connect these two lines a bit later. Let's make this line here. Let's connect these two. Let's put this. Let's give it some curvature. This is turning out really nice. So now we have this line here, this very slight line, but which is this one over here, which is very, very difficult to realize how to model it properly. But after some time, I managed to think over it. So let's take this one. I copy paste this curve over here so that we have the same curvature, and using the end snap, I'm going to move this somewhere over here. Now what this did was place an exact copy over there, but after studying the model hard, I know that this is a bit higher than this slight curve here is a bit higher than this one, so I'm going to adjust the points to match this. And then we need to follow the curve. I'm going to be deleting this point. And I'm going to be putting this somewhere over here using the narrow snap. Let's see. I'm not happy with the curvature here. If you notice carefully, you'll see that this surface that is going, that is created between these two curves, starts very narrow here and it goes wider as it goes down. So I'm going to be using this to align it. Let's put this one somewhere over there. We don't need to worry about how this curve meets this one. You'll see I have a trick up my sleeve that I will be using later on to show you how to do that properly. Let's take this one just a bit. No, I don't like it. Let's put this slightly inwards though. Bit higher, probably. I think we're okay. Now let me show you this tricky part over here. Using the mirror snap, I'm creating a new curve with which I'm going to split this one. So using split, I'm going to be splitting this in two. So we have one and two. Now I'm going to be blending this curve over here with this one. Wow. I think it's okay, just slight adjustments. Very nice. I guess we're good from here as well. Now, let's start creating this bottom curve over here. Using the endo snap, I'm starting this. It's not that I don't take this part over here under consideration, but I'm going to be modeling that later. It's not a detail that I'm leaving out, just so you know. Let's end this line somewhere here. Now, as you can see, what we see here in the side blueprint is actually this one. Let's put it there. In this case, we might need a few more points. So let's add a few using the insert node tool. Let's see. I guess this one, the top of this surface over here is supposed to be a bit more outwards than this one. So I will fix this in a few minutes. Let's do this one first. It's supposed to be like this. On the inside of this line, let's align this. I guess it's safe to assume that we're okay. So let me turn points on for this one to properly give tangency to these lines from this view. Excellent. This needs to be a bit more the outside. I think we're good here as well. Now let's take this line. You remember that I told you that we need it. I copy and paste it using the alt arrows to move it at the bottom. And if you carefully notice the reference photos, this one goes a bit inwards than this one. So let's place it somewhere here. And now using the blend curves, let's connect these two. You see what happened? No, I'm not happy with this at all. But only because this line wasn't modeled properly. So let's align this point using I guess we're good to go now. Let's make the blend curves. Nice. Nice, very nice. Maybe we need to tweak them just a bit. Wait, I think we're good now. Let's connect these two points. There's something strange here if you notice. Something I don't like with this bent curve as well. I think it's slightly off you on the side view. So let me match this properly. I guess is the error. Let's adjust it using this point over here. Let's adjust this point as well. Ah, now I guess we're good to go again. Quite happy with it. Something I don't like. As you can see now, these two curves cross here and it's going to be leading us to strange issues. So let me delete this one once more. Let's take these points. Let's move them. Whoops, I selected something I wasn't supposed to. Now we're getting somewhere. This one is very... So now let's once more adjust this one and make a straight line out of this. Now let's see it again. Perfect. This is exactly what we want. So let me save this file again. Remember to save often. Once you do big steps, remember to save in a new file. So what I need here also is a straight line. So if you notice, we can't create this surface here in one go, because as you can see, it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. We could do this using the paths command, but I want to have greater control over the surface. So let me create this line here using the near snap. Let's place it over there. Now, what we're going to do here is to create another curve. So, if you can see now, we have divided these surfaces in 1, 2, 3, 4 sides for this surface. 1, 2, 3, 4 sides for this surface. And 4 for the top surface as well. So, I guess this will be leading us into problem though. This surface over here. Let's fix. This curve. So, since I used an endpoint at this, where this line and this one meets, and I use narrow snap for this one, I guess this one, if I split this line with this one, these ones will also be tangent. But let me try using the match curve tool to make absolutely sure we leave these options unticked. I guess we're good with this one as well. Let's go to the top part of the plastic. I'll explain later this part over here. It's a bit tricky, but we'll get this soon. So let's make a straight line here. For a few parts of the plastic, I don't worry about the curvature here because it's going to be done afterwards. Let's take, if you notice carefully, this curve over here, it's going, well, you can't see it from the photos, but just because I studied actual bike, it's going outwards and it's somewhere here. Let's see. I'm drawing this curve over here. It's supposed to be here. So let me take this. As you can see, they match slightly. Let's take and make this one. And this is probably going outwards, like this. Now, as you can see, there's a slight bend here on this plastic. It's not very visible. Let me try to show you. Here, maybe you can notice that the reflection changes. Let me try a different view. I think you can see it clearer here. It goes somewhere like this. So, let's create this line one. Now, to create this bend, instead of creating this curve up to the top, I'm going to be doing it like this. You'll see why in a few minutes. So let's try to be a bit more thorough here. I guess we're good. Now let's try to adjust this using the side view. Goes. I probably need more points for this one. Let's see what's going on in the top view. So this one here is supposed to be somewhere here and it has this curvature out here. As you can see, this goes somewhere like we just need to follow this curve over here. You can see the blueprints don't match at all at this point. The front blueprint with the side. But this is only because of the camera lens. But I think I'm happy with the result so far. So let's create this curve as well. Let's see now. As you can see, it goes slightly outwards. I think we're good. Oh, we're not. This goes over here. I think now it's great. Let's try to use the front blueprint. Let's match this curve over here. Now let's make some slight adjustments. So that I think it's safe to add one more point in the middle and do a slight bend, just very slight. Maybe this one needs to be a bit more like this. Yep, we're good. Save again. I think we're almost ready to go. Now, this part of the plastic over here, let me find a nice view. Where is it? Here it is. It goes outwards. This is this part that shows here is actually this one. It starts outwards, goes inside, and it creates a slight depth over this plastic over here. So I will show you how to deal with this later, but let's try to make using the Neuro Snap. Let's create a new curve using this point. And we're going to be using fillet curves. Nice. Now, using the top view, you can see the top plastic here is a straight line. Let me adjust the point so that let's pull it over here. Mirror snap helps as well. Now let's make this one. So we need 2 points to make it tangent over here. So one will do for now. Let's adjust this one. Try some slight curvature. Now, using this curve, I'm going to split this one into 2 parts. And using the match tool, I'm going to make this tangent to the other line. We're good. Let's save once more. Now this line is completely off, but it doesn't matter for now. Let me see. I'm going to be, let me hide this first. Let me hide this pair of lines. Join them, hide them. Let's create this one. Now actually this we will be needing to create after some procedure I'm going to do there. So I guess we're done with the lines. I'm fairly happy with it, so I guess we'll be going on to create our surfaces. Save once more and let's go. So now that we have completed our curves, we're about to start modeling the actual surfaces of this front cowling. But before we do so, I'm going to show you a few adjustments I've made to these curves. I'm going to paste them right now. The yellow lines are the new ones and the red ones are the previous ones. The only reason I adjusted them was to align more properly to the blueprints. Actually, I moved points around, no big deal, because I was rushing it at the first part of the tutorial. As you can see, there aren't any differences in the strategy. The strategy still remains the same, just a few adjustments to the positions of the points. So I'm going to invert and delete the previous curves. I'm going to save this to a new file. So let's begin. I'm going to start with this surface. I want to explain that using the top view, I pushed this point just a bit above from its original position, which was somewhere around here. I changed the curvature so that I have this slight change in the curvature of the actual plastic, I'm going to be using patch for the surface, although I try to avoid it as much as I can. But I won't be needing any major adjustments in the surface, so that's why I'm preferring it. If you see the reflection here, it seems like it's going inwards at this point, and this was exactly what I wanted. So, if you remember the previous part of the tutorial, I had two separate lines here. I have both of these curves made tangent using this one. But in this case, I'm going to be joining these two. I'm going to be using network surface using these curves here so that I have this surface. Now, using a curve, I'm going to use the end of snap here and here, and I'm going to be deleting this one, this surface I just made with this curve I just did. So now using the network surface again, and using the surface edge this time, and making it using curvature, I'm going to make a surface that it transitions very smooth with the other surface before. Let me select the curves and hide them so that I show you how smooth it is. Nice. Let's go to the bottom part now. Using sweep to rails this time, using these two as rails and these two as cross-section curves, I'm going to create, let me preview. No, I don't want to maintain height like this. So you can see I have some strange wrinkles here. If you see the shaded version, you can see why. I don't need so much information here, so I'm going to be removing knots using the direction V. Let me take this out as well. This one, this one, this one. Actually, I don't need much information for this surface, so let me take out this one as well. I actually don't mind about where this surfaces meet, because I'm going to be deleting them very soon. So now the tricky part was this part over here. Let me show you this part. Very strange. If you can, I couldn't take very good pictures from the under of this plastic, but as you can see, it's roundish here. It's very strange. It fades here, it does some crease here, and then it meets to the bottom with a roundish edge. So this is a way I could do this. Using this curve, let me copy, paste it, and hide it so that I can keep my original line. Let me extend it slightly. I don't need to be extended very much from both edges. I'm going to be using pipe on 0.3 radius. Now I'm going to be deleting these three surfaces using the pipe. And let me hide these curves for now. So, let me merge these edges. Sometimes this happens when you're using the pipe tool. So now I'm going to be duplicating these edges, connect them, and using a sphere and using its center, this edge point, I'm going to be creating a surface of radius 1. Now, having selected these two curves, joint curves now, I'm going to be splitting them with this surface, and I'm going to be deleting both the sphere and these two curves. So, have the two remaining part of the edges here. If you can see. So, I'm going to be using blend curve, this one and this one. to create this nice smooth line between. Now, let me turn control points on. I'm taking this edge here and pushing it to the right using the arrow keys, just so it crosses this edge over here, this one. The reason I'm doing this is because I want to blend this surface here, this edge of this surface, with this one, which you're going to see right now. I'm going to delete this, hide this curve. Now, if I use the blend curve here, I'm creating a smooth passage from this edge here to this edge with no kinks, no strange curvatures, very nice and smooth. You actually need this to be so smooth, or you'll have problems creating this surface here. So, I'm going to use split edge using this endpoint, and now I'm going to blend surface, this one and this one, using tangents. Don't worry about this one, we'll fix it in a few minutes. So, now I'm going to use network surface with this here and our new curve. Let's preview it using tangency, not curvature this time. Let's see the result. Nice and smooth. Don't mind these seams over here. If you connect the surfaces, they won't show at all. I'm undoing it, so let me fix this thing here as well. I'm going to extend surface just a bit, I don't mind. And using my original curves, I'm going to delete this. I had these two curves before with no curvature at all. I had them just connected at that point, they're straight lines. So what I'm going to do is split them using this surface. I'm going to delete these parts here. Now I'm going to blend curve this one and this one to create a new one. Actually, because I want the original curves as well, I'm going to copy this, go back a few steps before splitting the line, the curves, hide them and paste my new curve, which I'm going to be using to delete this one to have a nice smooth result, nice smooth end over here. Now for the difficult part. I'm going to be using split edge once more, and I'm going to split this edge over here up to the point these two surfaces meet. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Now, let's merge. No, that doesn't mind. So, I'm going to be using blend surface here. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm right clicking, then using this surface 1, 2. Let me preview, see what's going on. I'm going to be using position this time. And this is exactly what I want. Exactly. Don't mind about the edges not being smooth. I'm going to fix those later. But check this out. Very nice and smooth. Maybe we can add a few shapes and see what's going to happen. Using perpendicular or snap. Even better. Great. Let's use the rendered view. Absolutely wonderful. Great. I'm happy with this, so I'm going on. Let me save. Let's go to this surface here. Now, let me do a network surface using the curve or the surface edge. I don't mind. It's the same thing because I'm going to be using position. And now for this surface at the top. Let me network surface these two. Very nice. Now this top part, if you check the blueprints, the reference photos very closely. It has a slight curvature here. Let me find a photograph that actually shows this. Here, take the reflection here. It goes, there's a slight bend over here. So that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to use paths once more. Now, if you can remember from before, like the surface down here, I made these curves, these two curves, tangent with a, let me, single, let me delete, let me split this using this one. This curve over here is tangent with this one I made sure before. So I'm going to be using paths for 1, 2, 3 curves. I'm going to be using 2 spans. I don't need more information than this. I have a double curve up here. So let's hide the lines, see what we have here. So how are we going to fix this now? If you try to fill it, it will fail. It was obvious because the edge here, the two edges of this surface are very closely to create a fillet. So I'm going to be using this curve over here. I'm going to be using pipe again. Let's use a 0.3 pipe. And I'm going to be deleting these two surfaces using the pipe. That's very nice. Now, just a simple blend curve. Let me split the edge over here. And let me do a blend surface. Tangency. Okay. Now, I'm going to do a network surface using these edges and this curve here. Let me see. Tangency. That's great. Let me hide the curves. Look at the smooth blend. Don't worry about this thing over here. It's the same procedure as we did before. I'm going to extend this. And delete it accordingly, but not at this point. Now, one of the tricky part of the surface was this point over here. It goes, let me show you. If you can see, it has a slight curvature here. It goes to the inside. I have a better blueprint, better reference photo. Check this out. It goes slightly outwards. It's very strange, but I found a way to do this as well. So I'm going to join these two surfaces, and I'm going to do a fillet. Let's see, one. No, it's too big. Oh, my mistake again. Let's see. I think it's great. So now, using the reference photo from behind, I'm going to split the edge where this curved part of the surface ends. Let's assume it's somewhere here. Now, I'm going to use blend curve once more using this and this. So I have this new curve over here, which I'm going to be using to delete that part. Now, let me duplicate this one. Actually, I have curves here. Let me take this one and this one. This I don't need yet. I'm going to paste these edges. And using this edge point, I'm going to move them right here. Actually, I don't need this part at this point either. So let me invert inside everything else. And let's see. Actually, I need these two curves in order to adjust them. I've studied the reference photos quite some time, so I know that this surface here goes slightly inwards. So that's what I'm going to do. This is the surface I'm talking about. And I'm going to take this one, two, maybe one. One, two, three. I'm using Control Alt and the arrow keys to move this just a tiny bit. I'm going to be finalizing this later, so it's no big deal at this point. So now I'm going to be using two sweep rails between this and this curve as rails. Use this edge over here as a cross section. Let me see. No, this is not what I want. So I think this one needs to be a bit on the inside, a bit more. Looks like I adjusted them wrong before, but I guess now we're good. So using swift rails, one, two, and three. The reason I'm not deleting the original curves is because I won't finalize the surfaces at this point. Maybe in the progress I might have to change a few things. So I'm keeping everything just in case I need to adjust something as I go on. So let me create a curve now. Let me see as a reminder how it goes. This curve here comes and just bends. So this is exactly what I'm going to do here. Let me drag it up to this point. Now there's a blinker here that doesn't help a lot, but I'm going to get it eventually. So I take this curve over here. Let me put it somewhere here. I select it, and by using setting PT, I'm going to set this to the X direction, to the Y direction, sorry, so that it's exactly at this depth. So now I'm just going to use a blend curve using this and this edge over here. Wow, that's great. Exactly what I wanted. So using this new curve here, we have this one created now. So using the side view, I'm going to use these two curves to delete this one. Let's see. Ah, that's great. But I think that the original curves be a lot more on the inside, so on two, maybe a bit less. Let's see again. Let me delete it. Because it goes on the inside. I think we're okay, but if I need to adjust anything, I'll do it as I go on. So let's create this connection here as well. Now that I have these curves, I don't need this, nor these. So I'm going to hide them. Now I'm going to create a new curve using this edge and this edge. Now I'm just going to create a new network surface using this surface edge, this edge, this one, and the new curve. Let's see what will happen. Absolutely wonderful. Actually, don't mind about these seams, we're going to be fixing them later, but this is the edge here worries me, so let me try to use network surface. This one, again the same things, but let me try loose. I guess it's almost the same. It doesn't really matter though, because I'm going to be using a fillet later on, so it has this slight bend. Maybe I need a different, just hitting Ctrl Z here to undo. Let me reach up to this point before deleting, and let me take this curve just a bit more. Let me blend these two curves. One, two. Just a quick tip, you can select this point here and you can use scale to place it exactly where you want without losing its tangency. I think maybe this needs just to be a bit lower. Let me do it again. The blinker here does our job very difficult. Anyway, I think I'm gonna go with this one, no matter how it turns out. Since I'm going to be fixing this later. Polish surface edge, so that we have a nice, smooth result. Okay, I guess I'm happy with it. So, we're done with the creation of the main surface. Let me hide the curves to show it to you. It will improve a lot when the fillets will be created and it will be smoothed out. But for now, it's exactly what we wanted. So, let's go on to new parts.